Welcome to this how-to video from cBioPortal. In this video, I'm going to show you one of the ways you can get started using cBioPortal, which is exploring a study in our interactive study view. We'll start by selecting a study, and for this example, I'm going to choose this TCGA pan-cancer atlas study of esophageal adenocarcinoma. When I select the study, these two buttons at the bottom become active. In this video, we're going to click the Explore Selected Studies button. We have another video about running queries, linked here and in the description below. Clicking this button brings us to Studyview, where we see a number of different charts which summarize the different data available for this study. Let's take a look at a few of these different charts. Up here, we can see a table showing the breakdown of cancer types represented in this cohort. And here, we see a table showing which molecular profiles are available and how many samples each profile has data for. As we continue looking, we can see this table, which summarizes the mutation data. It shows us the most frequently mutated genes. We can see P53 is mutated in 158 samples, or 86.8% of the cohort. Continuing along, we also have a table that shows us the most frequently copy number altered genes. We can see that CDQN2A is deleted in 71 samples, or 39% of the cohort. And there are a number of genes, all located on the same cytoband here, 11Q13.3, that are all amplified in around 35% of samples. We can also see data presented in histograms, like this one that shows the age at which individuals in this cohort were diagnosed with their cancer. We also see a number of pie charts, for example, this one, which shows the breakdown of the cohort by sex. Notice that when I hover my mouse over the pie chart, a tooltip appears showing the same data in tabular form. Also, note that every chart has this menu in the top right corner with some additional options. As you can hopefully start to appreciate, it's easy to explore the available data for a cohort by browsing these charts. However, there's a lot more you can do. All of these tables and charts are interactive, so you can use them to filter the cohort down to particular subsets. For example, I can select samples with P53 mutations by clicking this box and then the Select Samples button below. And now we see all the charts updating to show only the features of those 158 samples with a P53 mutation. You can continue to apply additional filters to further refine and explore your samples of interest. For example, clicking a slice of the pie chart to look only at female patients. You can see the currently applied filters presented here at the top of the page. As you apply filters, you can always save these subsets of samples as virtual cohorts with this button here, or as groups with this menu here. You can also explore individual patients by clicking here. To learn more about any of these features, check out some of our other videos and tutorials linked in the video description. It's also important to understand that we don't show all charts by default. Use the Charts menu to add additional charts to view. Here, you'll see many additional data elements to display, any of which can be added by clicking the checkbox. There are also different types of charts available in these different tabs, but note these are dependent on data availability, so some, like arm-level CNA, won't be available for all studies. We hope you found this video helpful. For a deeper introduction to Studyview, check out some of the other resources shown here and in the video description.